most of the time I spend doing quantum error correction and questions that relate quantum information with quantum many-body physics. Well, it tells us that we can manipulate quantum information in principle for a very long time. And I'm trying to see what's the best way to do this, what's the most economical way to do this. People are realizing new ways to perform error correction in fault-tolerant quantum computation. I think these are core questions. What we're doing is very theoretical, right? So you say, oh, we've solved this question, we've solved this question. We know how to perform this task efficiently. And efficiently means things don't blow up exponentially. That's, you know, at the first level of approximation, that's all you care about. But then when you revisit these questions, it's like, okay, it's not exponential, but it's really, really hard. And the numbers that come out can be very bad. And now people are finding new tricks, a lot of new tricks to make all these schemes much more efficient. And that's very encouraging. I think it tells us that maybe we haven't really found all the best ways to manipulate quantum information. When we talk about quantum information, we always have this goal in mind, which is building a quantum computer. But finding other application, I think, is very important. So spin-offs of our research. I think that in the past few years, we've seen a lot of nice new connections between theoretical quantum information and other disciplines of physics, such in particular condensed matter physics. So I'm quite excited by these connections, in particular new phases of matter, topological insulators, topological superconductors. So and these things connect to quantum error correction and fault-tolerant quantum computation.